Standing on a special platform, encapsulated in their heavy spacesuits, Alexander Gerst and his crewmate, NASA astronaut Serena Onnen-Chancellor, slowly sink into a 12-meter deep pool with a life-size replica of the International Space Station. Assisted by instructors in diving suits, astronauts train for 6 hours a day for all kinds of situations they may encounter during their spacewalks. Gerst, who flew to the ISS in 2014, says doing it the second time is a bit easier.
The first time you fly, you have the problem that you get a lot of detail. People tell you a lot of things that you can never remember all.
Astronauts also train inside the replica station, especially for emergency situations, because 400 kilometers above the Earth, there's no point in calling an emergency number. As astronauts train, instructors follow and evaluate every move. Other training involves science experiments that can be done only in space. For instance, tests with cancer cells.
In weightlessness, we can suspend them in the fluid, and we actually found that they behave differently up there, but more close to how they behave in the human body.
The fresh crew will also bring the first of its kind mobile assistant, called CIMON, built by the Airbus Corporation.
It's meant to be a social, interactive, free-flying object who shall assist the crew during extensive tasks and to reduce stress.
Equipped with artificial intelligence, this 32-centimeter wide ball with a screen displaying a simple face also has its own propulsion. CIMON will help astronauts solve various problems and provide entertainment.
Great, let's play your favorite hits.
Scientists also want to see if artificial intelligence could serve as a mediator during long deep space flights.
To have something like CIMON on board, it is meant to help during this specific situation to react with a good countermeasure, to solve the situation in a group and to lead to mission success.
Alexander Gerst says he cannot wait to sit again by the ISS window and look at our planet. George Putich, VOA News.